Hello, Dissenters! It's another RimWorld day, and as soon as I pushed the record button, I was greeted with a new recruit. Ilarion, with a 1.7% chance, has been recruited by Onesin. Welcome to the colony. Brand new doctor, cook, crop grower, and miner. Lots of varied passions and interests. You'll make a very welcome member of the new group. Age 34, and I say new group because we've had so many people die recently that it feels like an all-new group, doesn't it? Now, for both of our new colonists, I have yet to give them a work schedule, so they've just been kind of doing anything that they want to do. No longer. We've got 6 hours of joy time scheduled, 8 hours of work, a couple hours of anything in between, and I hope that I have no night owls. Let's take a look at that as we witness the completion of the kitchen sterile tile. Looking very clean, very tidy, very shiny. All right, I'm just gonna scroll through and look at the traits on the bottom left. If you see any that say night owl, we're gonna have to make a change. And it's gonna be really embarrassing if I blindly pass one up. I don't think I have. We're looking good. Today, we're gonna begin work on our new dining hall. It's gonna be grand, it's gonna be vast, it's gonna require a number of pillars in between to support the roof. This is too wide across for a roof, so it's gonna have a gap, at least at the beginning, but that's okay. And since I want the wall to be here and I don't want to have to look at this ugly wall, I'm gonna go ahead and mine out one block all the way around so that we can rebuild out of granite, which if I'm not mistaken is much prettier. Let's take a look and find out. Well, it's not prettier, it's neutral, but regular stone cave wall is -2, so 0 is better than -2, as you might expect. Now, what else are we looking forward to doing today? Well, you might notice I have at long last destroyed the stockpile for the old freezer, and I've moved everything, by everything I mean what little we have, up into the new freezer, which needs some lights, but I'm hesitant because we're not really doing so hot as far as generating electricity goes, so I'm gonna start with 4 lamps. That might even be overkill. I'd also like today to complete construction at long last on this geothermal generator, which has been half-baked, half-finished for too long. Speaking of furnishing our new freezer, you might be curious how we're doing on the food situation. We've managed to balance out back to 34 simple meals, which isn't a lot, mind you, but it is a nice buffer, at least for a couple of days. We've been hunting like crazy, and we've been butchering that venison up, readying it to be prepared with our crops, which are actively being harvested. Fedosia replanting some potatoes in here. We've got heel root that is 99% grown. That's exciting because we are out of heel root. And looking over onto our spring outdoor crops, potatoes at 99% as well. Fortuitous indeed. The corn is going to take much longer, but 2 giant potato harvests really going to inflate our numbers here. Going up to 800 just by butchering all these animals. We're making kibble for the dogs. I have not forgotten you, my pooches. Babushka, you will not starve to death, not yet. So I'm pretty pumped about catching up on food. I'd like to have a few thousand before the seasons are over and we return back to winter. Let's take a look. I believe we are pretty much done mining. Almost everything. Apparently I missed a block or two, but that's all right. Let's haul all of these loose sandstone chunks out of here. Get the marble gone while we're at it because it just cover for potential enemies in the future. And designate a bit of strong, sturdy granite. Why did I have 2 blanks here? That's where we probably mined out, I guess? I don't know exactly where I want the doors to be, is what I'm trying to say. And I know I'm gonna have to come in here and patchwork things up just a little bit, but that's okay. I believe the door is probably going to go equal to wherever the granite auto doors here are. So for example, they are 1, 2 blocks off even with the cooler. So if I was gonna do the same thing, it'd be 1, 2. The door would be here technically, but that's strangely close to where this other door is gonna be. Maybe that's okay. It seems odd. Let's check on the cargo pods while I consider this. Lynx skin. I don't know if I've seen any lynxes. Heel root has died from being unharvested. Surely not these. These are all 99% grown. We've got so many growers now. We got a new one, Ilarion. Remember how I said such varied interest Ilarion has? I've got you backing us up. So we got 3 people dedicated to farming, which should be good enough for all of this junk that we're gonna have to deal with. Finally, our lights are done. People can see what they're eating here in the freezer. And I've decided how I want the doors to go, even though it's not correct, technically. This is the middle. It's the sixth block in. There's five blocks on either side, so it's the middle of this opening. Not going to be even with these doors, but that's okay. And, of course, we have to do the ever-annoying double auto door fixture, which means, yes, even more components are going to be necessary. We have zero, at least in our stockpile, which is completely full. Let's use a little bit of that steel now. I've been meaning to do this for a while. There's no need to be greedy. So I'm going to use some paved tile, because this is grass and dirt, which is just a bit bothersome to me. Unfortunately, we can't reach more than one block in on top of the geothermal generator, so this cannot be paved. It just simply cannot be reached. And around the other geothermal, why don't we go ahead and pave it as well? Just so that we don't have to worry about it catching fire and burning all the steel that we've got in here already. Just a nice, clean, good project. And simultaneously, I believe we do have the granite, preemptively build the wall. We're gonna need one if we ever get to complete the geothermal to protect it from the raiders. And we'll make a granite door here on the front. That'll keep our builders busy for quite some time to come. Onesin, deconstruct that wall. Thank you so very much. And I'm gonna replace it pretty much immediately with a new granite door. This is where we are going to be dining, and I've got grand plans for you. Let's see what kind of stone we've got. Almost 700 marble and 1200 granite and a bit of sandstone. I want to mix and match the flooring in here to make for some delicious looking tile. We're going to need some lumber as well to make a slew of tables and chairs. Let's order some chopping of some trees right now while I'm thinking about it, including those trees immediately surrounding all of our buildings. That's less cover for our potential enemies to take in the near future. I am so excited. Okay, stop pulsating the screen, Etalyx. Tell me what you're so excited about. Is it the first potato harvest with 666 devil potatoes lying around outside with even more being picked up by four people simultaneously? It's so fast. Is it that, Etalyx? No. Is it the corn? Why would it be the corn, you imbecile? Think clearly. Is it the kitchen? Is it so pretty? Is it the fact that we're making a new auto door? Is the fact that we're almost done. Okay, fine, I'll just tell you. It's the component assembly bench. We built it earlier. I don't know when it's built, that's all that matters. Let's add a bill right now. From here, we can make components forever. And the beauty of this is that components require 25 steel, and guess who has almost 5,000 steel? Yes, that's right, it's me. And guess who has a crafter who's not busy crafting anything right now, as far as I can tell, because Rob went straight to work making these components. We now have a nearly infinite source of components. Well, it's not infinite, is it? When we run out of steel, then it becomes limited. But for now, it feels infinite because the sky is the limit when you have 5,000 steel. What good does all of this food do if nobody's around to haul it in? I've had to make some changes to our work schedule. Even though Nell has a passion for growing crops, I had to demote that to a 2 so I could raise hauling to a 1. I didn't know who else to make number 1 hauler, so Nell is assisting us here by cremating some of these old bodies, these old skeletons that have been lying around in the dump stockpile for eons now. Visitors have arrived, and they would like to trade. Okay, let me think about this first. Get ones in on the job. Go see what they have. But speaking of hauling, I thought, how come the animals aren't helping us out? Well, unfortunately, only 3 of our huskies are trained for hauling. I never checked the boxes for Akira and Callie, even though I obedience trained them. So 2 more huskies hauling is pretty important in my opinion. Now, what do you all have? They want to buy, but they only have 98 silver. Poor visitors, they're selling Molotov cocktails, drugs, and 5 good medicine. I will buy the 5 good medicine and the 5 overly priced components. And in return, I'll sell you some dead guy clothes, some frag grenades, and I'm gonna try to even this out to 0 if I can. We're gonna dump on them some junky weapons and some fine meals, which are worth $20 a piece. That's not bad. So all this stuff is going to be outside deteriorating unless we can haul it in. Nell, you got your work cut out for you. And I'm very confused because we just recruited you, but you're in between Midori and Calhoun on my list for some reason. Wow, this is a very popular rec room, isn't it? A little bit dark in here, but they probably still enjoy it if I had to guess. Decent bedroom. Where's decent rec room? This is a good quality billiards table times two. And we got chess. We got lights. The only thing we really don't have, I suppose, to spruce this place up are some potted plants. But that's simple enough. Let's put two in here because we don't want to overdo it with the potted plants. We have to replant them every so often. And power's looking solid as well. We've started work on the surrounding barrier from the geothermal generator, but we don't have all the components necessary, but we might now. We've got seven in a stockpile. I think we hauled them in already. Good job, everybody. You are on top of your game today. I'm gonna go ahead and allow the smithy to be made too. Now that we have a constant supply of components, provided that we're crafting. There's the red notification over here. That's a little bit disconcerting. Ilarion has a major break risk. It's the morning. That's usually when they're feeling the best, right? Look at all that. Minus 55 mood. Wake up and smoke leaf addiction withdrawal. Smoke leaf is up to 85%, so he's almost over the smoke leaf. But wake up is only at 50. And two permanent gunshot injuries in the right eye. Wow, your vision is going to be very poor. And you got a scar on the other. I love all those little details. I think that's super cool. Why are you getting the best medicine that money can buy? Switch everyone down to herbal, please. Yeah, I'm fully expecting you to go berserk, Ilarion. You're going to be a little bit of trouble until you get over those addictions. Hey, look at the pooches hauling the potatoes for us. It's exactly what I wanted to see. Speaking of which, are any of them trained yet? Do we even have a handler? We do. Bridge is the rancher. Is hauling components to the geothermal generator, you hero. Let's get that power juicing into the system. We're gonna beeline it in. Straight over. Nobody catch this on fire, please. Now, I don't want to stretch this across the floor because they think that power conduit is ugly. So we're gonna connect it up to the top first. There's only gonna be one connection. No backup. Oh well. And then down here, we're gonna get some paved concrete. Three across, all the way down to protect our line, protect our little cable, and one more paved tile. That'll keep everybody real nice and busy. I'm going on cruising, 3x speed, because everyone is just doing their job right now. We're almost up to 1,000 food, and that's on top of 112 meals. Rob is completing components. We're working like a well-oiled machine, and we've got room to grow. Empty space. I can put whatever I want in here. I'm gonna make it a yoga room. Skipping ahead just a bit here, I've met a pirate merchant on the comms console, and I'm trading up a lot of stuff. Why? To get a bionic leg. The more legs we can get, the better, I think. But what am I having to give up? Superior parka, normal parka, lots of good clothes that we could use come this winter. Frag grenades. I'm giving away some medicine-related things like penicillin, which I know what you're thinking. Don't do it. It's okay. We can make more. I do have 40 neutroamines still. So that's still on the crafting table. And I'm giving away all 35 of our mortar shells. Maybe a bad deal. But I want that bionic leg. And that little extra bit of silver. But Etalyx, if you didn't make this out of sterile tile, you could have afforded all of that. Shh. Quiet, you. Don't tell me what to do. Today has been a blessed day. Randy Random has given us peace and prosperity, allowing us to harvest even the corn without blight, the longest growing crop. Look at how much is accumulating here to go put in our stockpiles. But it's not just one patch, it's two almost ready to go. A bunch of heal root is on the way, and I think I'm gonna turn smoke leaf after this is grown, possibly into more cloth. Speaking of cloth, let's say we use some of that cloth now. I'd like to replace every single one of our animal sleeping spots with a good cloth bed. And right now we've got 7 different animals, right? So let's make sure we can build and afford more than 7 animals in the future. Cloth bed at the end of every bed. I like it. 45 cloth apiece though. So our 600 is gonna go very fast, but that's okay. That's a good start for now. and it's gonna look very nice and pretty. What doesn't look pretty is all these dirt pathways. I know, I'm aware. And that's why Midori is now helping us build. Manise, I appreciate the effort that you're putting into things. Midori is going out to build the paved tile now. The geothermal's not doing anything for us until we get the power conduit connected up to the grid. That's why you shouldn't queue everything up simultaneously. But with three people building, hopefully this will be good enough. It'll happen. Just give us some time. Today has been very trader heavy. I don't know why. This is the second pirate merchant and third overall trader that I've come across. We're making more of our mortar shells after depleting our stock for the last trade. Component assembly still going nicely. We've got 13 penicillin back. And overall, Illyrian has died because of stoned on smoke leaf. All in a day's work, Randy Random. All in a day's work. How did this happen? Was he even broken? I don't understand. I know you had a smoke leaf dependence. How did you die to stoned on smoke leaf? That must have been the first joint that I made. Look, there's one smoke leaf joint. What kind of condition did you have? What did you roll in that joint? This must be some powerful stuff. Well, guys, the Illyrian giveth, the Illyrian taketh away. I enjoyed having an extra farmer, miner, cook, and doctor. But alas, now everyone is going to be very sad because a colonist has perished. Unfortunately, my little colonist, I really need that good power armor helmet. So we're going to have to desecrate your corpse. Normally, I allow the colonists to be buried with whatever they were wearing before, but we need your stuff. Let's be fair. Now we will prioritize burying you. Naked you came into this world. Okay, actually you came in with armor. But nonetheless, naked you shall depart in an excellent quality marble sarcophagus. I didn't have any attachment to you, Illyrian. Ryoko Onesen is the crafter, the author of this beautiful artwork. But you will still be remembered fondly with a desirous illness. An engraving on this sarcophagus shows Bridges smacking Illyrian while capturing him as he twists in pain. He's snarling with the fury of defeat. There's a rock in the upper part of the image. It's a Romanesque style. This is the story of the capturing of Illyrian. You will be remembered as a captive. It's a sad day. We had a colonist die. Calhoun's gonna smoke a joint in your memory. Hopefully this one's not as deadly as the one that you partook of, Illyrian. That must have been laced with something. Everyone smoking in memory of Illyrian. The newest slash most recently departed colonist that we've ever seen. Died in the same day that you were recruited. How about that? Now that doesn't happen every day. Colonists may die every day, but that doesn't happen every day. Now where are we in the progress meter? We're looking good here. Geothermal, that much closer to being complete. Bridge is coming out just to knock one block out of the park. The new dining hall is about ready to be detailed, which will have to happen next episode. And I've got two coolers coming in to help out here inside of the kitchen where we're going to put some more vents in the future. And corn, potatoes, everything being harvested. We're up over 2,000 food, 140 meals nearly. Looking pretty good. Death of a colonist notwithstanding. Thank you all so much for watching another episode of RimWorld. I do hope you've enjoyed it. The colony is getting better and better, despite the minor setbacks that we're having to deal with. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you all next time back in RimWorld.